Welcome to the Noonday Meditation with Wayne Vernon.
Our ministry partner of note today is Luke. Luke, the writer of the Gospel of Luke and also the Book of Acts, is not mentioned in the first 15 chapters of the Book of Acts, except the fact that it's intimated in Acts chapter 1, verse 1. However, beginning with Acts chapter 16, he begins to be identified, or he identifies himself with several of the activities that took place in the book of Acts. Luke, in my mind, is one of the most significant ministry partners of the Apostle Paul that we will ever meet. However, his humility is outstanding. It is just amazing. Luke is a medical doctor and a traveling companion of the Apostle Paul. But not only that, he is one of the primary historians of the early church. Maybe the best gauge of how meaningful Luke was to the Apostle Paul can be seen in some of the statements that the Apostle Paul makes of him. In Colossians 4 and the verse 14, Paul speaks of him as a dear friend. Our dear friend Luke, the doctor, send greetings. In Timothy, 2 Timothy chapter 4 and the verse 11, the Apostle Paul, who is now in incarceration, says, "Only Luke is with me." Think of it. Think of being imprisoned and, you know, aging and having health issues, because some people suggest that the thorn in the flesh that Paul speaks about was actually a medical condition that he had. But can you imagine that he says, "Only Luke is with me"? His personal physician, traveling physician, is with him. Philemon 23 and 24, "Epaphras, my fellow prisoner in Jesus Christ, sends greetings, and so do Mark, Aristarchus, Demas, and Luke, my fellow workers." Paul acknowledges him and identifies him as a fellow worker. Friends, Luke took time to dedicate his life and his profession, his vocation, to supporting a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, called to proclaim the gospel to the whole world. He became a traveling physician and most likely was very helpful, not just to Paul, but with the Christian community experiencing so much persecution. It's no doubt that many of the believers were hurt and that he may have attended to them and supported them during their time of pain. Then the question I ask is, what would church history be like had it not been for Luke, who provided details that no other has provided? You know, we really do not have to be in the limelight. We do not have to be preachers. Our gift may not be in working miracles and performing signs and wonders, but whatever God has gifted us to do, let us do it with all the strength, commitment, dedication that we can find. The question is to you today, what is your profession? How could you be of value to the body of Christ? How could you utilize your profession for the glory of God? What opportunities is God opening up for you to be supportive to someone, or to receive support from someone as you advance the kingdom of God? These are questions we ask as we read the story of Luke, an impactful story, a great man of God. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen.
Thank you for listening to the Noonday Meditation with Pastor Wayne Vernon. Please forward this study to your friends, your relatives, associates, neighbors, and all those persons in your social network. If you have a prayer request, please feel free to communicate with us, and we will commit to supporting you in prayer. Until we meet again tomorrow, Shalom.